So we are back with a gentleman who will play a couple home games here this year at Barclays Center in Brooklyn, right in the neighborhood. It's the reigning NEC Coach of the Year from St. Francis, New York. Glenn Breyka joins us. And Coach, some were surprised that you were able to make so much progress so quickly last year and get right into the mix and be a tough out.
Yeah, we were very happy with our season. We had a lot of first-year guys who I think responded. We had lost a lot of our scoring from the previous year, but the guys stepped up, and we struggled early, but those guys got experience, and I think it paid off down the road.
And now Dre Calloway back, and a number of different scoring options. It's kind of an equal opportunity team almost.
Yeah, I think we're very deep, and I think we're very balanced. Last year, we didn't have anyone on the all-conference teams, but I think that's a result of our balance and our depth. You know, Dre coming back should really help because it gives us two legitimate point guards for this season, along with Brent Jones.
Yeah, but one player, I mean, you might not have an all-league player, but I think Jalen Cannon is very close. He is a special type of player.
Well, not many guys get 19 and 20 rebounds their first year in college basketball, so we're real excited about him. And, you know, he's added to his game. He's stepping out a little bit, you know, and increasing his range. And, you know, we're looking for him to be a little hungrier offensively in the low post, which he's kind of responded to earlier in the season.
All right, Glenn, not only the Barclays Center here, but just the surrounding area, and we know that St. Francis is relatively close. This is a great area to go to college, isn't it?
It really is. You know, Tim, when I grew up, it wasn't like that. Guys went away and stuff like that, but the whole area is transformed, and the Barclays Center is just adding to that, and it's just exploding. I was here for an exhibition game last week, the Nets and the Celtics, and it was sold out.
Right.
I mean, it was mind-boggling, and you could feel the energy and the electricity when you walk in the building. And the whole neighborhood, really all of Brooklyn, is just taking off.
And it's helped you recruit an interesting mix of players. It's not just, you know, guys from the city, guys from Brooklyn. You have international players that are coming in here that you're counting on.
Yeah, you know, I like to target the city and the surrounding areas, but I also like to target international players, even more so than guys from around the country, because I think New York is a great place for an international kid. I think they're comfortable here, they're mature, and they really enjoy the experience.
Coach, we appreciate the time, and we'll see you soon.
Thanks, Dave. Thanks, Tim.
Okay, Glenn Breyka, the head coach of St. Francis, New York. Dave Popkin, Tim Capstraw with you at Barclays Center in Brooklyn here on NEC Social Media Day. And it's not very often we get a holding court veteran with us here, a former NEC player at St. Francis and now the head coach at his alma mater entering his first year. Rob Krimmel joins us. And, well, you've taken that, you know, appearance on holding court and really developed it into a very successful career. Do you attribute most of your success to that?
All of it. I owe it all to Coach Capstraw. Everything to Coach Capstraw. Absolutely.
So we have him to blame if you win four games this year.
Oh, yes.
Easy.
Yes.
But you're not going to because Umar Shannon is back, and you have a lot in the cupboard this year. I think a dark horse team.
Umar obviously is a kid in our league that can give you 15 to 20 points a night. And when you have a guard like that, it makes, as a coach, makes your job a little bit easier. But some guys last year got some valuable minutes, some young kids. Earl Brown has done a great job over the summer, and Ollie Jackson, Stephon Wyatt, and then some kids, Anthony Irvin and Tony Peters, the senior captains, have done a great job leading the ship, especially off the court.
Well, Coach, you've been a player. You've been an assistant coach. You have a great feel for the school. The transition to being a head coach might be a little bit easier for you, but how has that been?
It's been great, and it's a great point because of my familiarity with the league and with the school. I know where the keys are, where the lights are, and some of the things that might be a challenge initially, but the support at St. Francis is tremendous, and from the alumni and from the people that work there, it's been a lot of fun.
You and I joked around before the show today and said, well, you know, it's always snowing in Loretto and all this, and you said, we love it. It's a tough place to come and play. You got to come to the mountain, and you have great fans there, a great little facility that makes a lot of noise, and that's a tough place to play.
It is, and we want to continue to make Loretto, Pennsylvania, one of the toughest gyms in the Northeast Conference, and our fans are tremendous, not only our student body, but the people from the community. They come out and support us, whether it's sunny or snowing.
There's a great tradition at St. Francis for basketball, obviously, over a lot of years. What's it going to take for you to get back to that elite level in the Northeast Conference?
And that's one of the great things about the job we have today is that the tradition has already been established. And one of the things we try to do is reach out to those alumni and reach out to those people that understand what makes St. Francis such a special place. And for our guys to understand that they've got to win off the court before we can win on the court. Win in the classroom, win in the community, just make winning an attitude.
Rob, good luck with it, and we will see you very soon.
Thank you very much.
Okay, the head coach of St. Francis, PA, the Red Flash, Rob Krimmel, joining us here in Brooklyn. Being joined now at Barclays Center by the youngest head coach in Division I. He's the new head man for Wagner College, Bashir Mason, 28-year-old head man. And let's talk a little bit about that. You know, in an interview, how can you convince Walt Hamline, hey, I can be the guy?
I think I've been doing that. He's been sitting in on practices and watching a little bit. And there hasn't been much of a drop off from the intensity that he saw the last 2 years. So I think that showed him that he really made the right choice.
What did you learn from working with Dan and Bob Hurley?
A lot, really. I played for Danny in high school, so I come from that same brand of basketball. We're all from Jersey City, so that made us work as a staff the last 2 years. And really, his intensity level, what he brought every day, and not being a corner cutter as a coach, getting our players to believe in that, that's certainly what I take away from him.
Well, you've got a deep roster. You've got talent returning. Tell us a little bit about it. First of all, I know some of your players. You got to tell me about Juwan Anderson.
Juwan Anderson, explosive scorer, explosive athlete. But for me as a coach, he's still a freshman, hasn't played a college game yet. I don't want to put that pressure on him to sort of go out there and try to lead us and do some things that he might be capable of later in the future. But, as a freshman, I don't want to do that. I would say we're sort of a veteran team where we've returned a lot from last year. The challenge for him is getting him to figure out how do he fit into a team that won 25 games without disrupting a pretty good flow that we got going.
Yeah, that's why I asked you too, because I have a great familiarity with the team, because I love Kenny Ortiz's leadership, Latif Rivers' all-around game in the backcourt. Yeah. Jonathan Williams is a complete player.
Yeah.
You've got some pieces there. The big guy inside, Fullahan, he can do it.
Yeah. I love that guy.
You love that guy.
He's a game changer. He's a good defensive player.
Block some shots.
Yeah.
For me, it's been defense nonstop since we started. I think we have enough talented guys on offense. I want to establish a culture of defense and rebounding and playing with that toughness that I really believe will help us win a championship.
All right, one of the top contenders for the NEC crown, Bashir Mason and Wagner. Pick second this year. Well, Tim, we've talked to everyone now, and it's like spring training in baseball. It seems like everybody's going to win it. I'm more confused than I was when we started.
Well, this is the time of year that I used to like. I used to think my team was going to be good this time of year. So I used to really enjoy this. But, hey, what you got to witness was there's an awful lot of talented young coaches that really know what they're doing. A lot of guys, a lot of youth. And vitality, and I really think that's going to carry over and really do some real positive things on both sides, both the men and the women's side of the Northeast Conference.
Yeah, I think so. The women, number 15 in the RPI last year, and they're playing a lot of tough non-conference foes, so you can expect that to continue. And you mentioned it with the coaches. That's really where it starts. That's the face of the program, and a lot of these guys have had success here and bounced, Dan Hurley to Rhode Island, Jim Ferry to Duquesne. And good young coaches have stepped in. We mentioned it a couple times. Wouldn't mind playing for any of these guys.
Yeah, they're just the charisma, the personality, and a number of them have a history at their school, whether it be they were the assistant with the head coach or they, went to school there and previously came back. I think it's a wonderful opportunity. I'm going to say it again. The top three teams in the Northeast Conference, it's the most talent that has ever been in the history of this conference.
Do you have a pick?
I think, listen, I always do it because I don't want to do it to a guy I really like, Bashir Mason, but the Wagner College. See, I just like the way he carries himself. Mm-hmm. I could play for that guy, and I think Wagner is going to get it done.
Hard to argue with that. I'll go with LIU to play devil's advocate, and that's going to do it for us from Barclays Center in Brooklyn. We appreciate you joining us here from NEC Social Media Day, and we'll see you at the gym.